Hello, I'm Tom Wright. Welcome to NT Wright Online. I want to introduce you to a new course that we're offering on Paul's letter to the Ephesians. I've often reflected that if Martin Luther and the other 16th century reformers had made Ephesians, rather than Galatians and Romans, the centre of their theological exposition, the whole course of Western history might have been different. Because they were able to interpret those letters in one way, but in Ephesians, Paul says something which didn't quite get caught that way, namely that through God's purpose in Christ, heaven and earth are to come together, and that that coming together of heaven and earth is reflected in the unity of the church across the division between Jew and Gentile, and that that itself is then going to be reflected in the coming together of the church as a new family, a new humanity, including, interestingly, the joining together of man and woman in marriage. So Paul has got in this letter some quite different things to say about the way God has revealed mysteries which have been lain hidden for many generations, things that he has discerned through Scripture, things that he's discerned through meditating on who Jesus is and what he's accomplished. And in this letter, we're going to be exploring many extraordinary themes as Paul grapples with the questions of how God's power has defeated all the powers of the world, powers which were very prevalent in Western Turkey in his day when he's writing this letter, and then how that victory is to be worked out through the battles that the church itself still has to fight, battles for holiness, battles for unity, battles in what we might call spiritual warfare. It is a delight to see how Paul handles these and brings them together with elegance and with power. I want to invite you then to explore these themes with me as we go through this course on Ephesians. I don't think you'll be disappointed by this. These are great ideas put forward in powerful words. Paul may be in prison, but he still has a whole lot to say.